All aboard! It's Jang here with a Playmobil Wildlife series set with a very descriptive name. It's called Jungle Animals with a researcher and off-road vehicle. Let's go ahead and take a look at what comes in this set before it even gets built. And the answer is a lot of stuff comes in this set. There's everything, and it makes for a really nice display. A lot of really solid, good components. First up is this animal habitat, which presents a number of varied types of terrain and situations for your animals to be active in and around. The tree has multiple colors of foliage, creating a little bit of a canopy up there. You can see an orangutan with two babies hanging from the arm. We'll take a look at the animals up more closely just by themselves as well. You see some vines back there, and the vines themselves have other types of foliage and flowers that are growing off of them. You can see the roots of the tree there growing kind of like fig tree roots. Got a tiger and a tiger cub up here, and then this archway, which presents some protective space underneath where you can hide animals in there or they can sleep in there. You've got quite a bit of grassland out to the side with some different types of foliage, again, different types of plants with more different colors. You've got a snake right there, and there is a hidden feature. As you can see, this rock right here doesn't look quite the same. Maybe you notice there's a seam around the edge. Well, you can hide animals that are small enough under the rocks, and the only ones that are included that are small enough in this set are these scary red scorpions. So that said, let's take a closer look at these. The scorpions themselves are pretty nicely detailed, but of course they're so small, you're not actually going to be able to move them. You can't articulate the tail and move the stinger forward and open up and close the pinchers or anything, but I think they look just fine as they are. Here's the snake, which has a face on it, and it comes kind of coiled up like this, so you can display it on the ground. You can have it moving around on the ground. It looks a little bit awkward over here where the coil kind of crosses itself, but you see what they were going for. Also, this can be hung from a tree. There's a branch where the orangutans were. You can put this there instead, so you can have it kind of hanging from up above, even more creepy like that. Speaking of the orangutans, here they are. Once again, one adult and two babies. The young ones are identical. You can see multiple colors used here for the face, as well as nice sculpting to the molds. They just have really nice faces, all of them. And you can articulate the adult quite a bit. You can move the hand up. You can move these legs independently, forward and back, while he's swinging around. He or she is swinging around. And you've got little peg-sized hooks for the hands, so you can attach that to things like vines. So this entire vine here all has that same size all around it, so you can hook it that way. Also has little opposable thumbs on the feet, the thumb style of toe down there, and you can attach things there, because these guys in real life are very, very handy with their digits. You can also move the head up and down, so it can be looking up or it can be looking down as you want. Whereas these little ones here, they can't be reposed, but they do have the little hook for the hand, so you can still attach them as well. And let me just attach this one on the side so you can see it kind of swinging around, having a little extra fun. You see, it will stay like that. And similarly, they've got the same thing on one of the feet, so it can be hanging out like that. Here's the tiger and cub, and these are both textured in the plastic itself and painted on top of that. So they come out looking really good. Not the greatest look in the eyes, I guess, but overall these are very nice looking to me. And they have similar articulation to the adult orangutan. You can move the head down, or you can move it up so it's roaring up into the air. You can adjust the angles of all of the legs so you can make it really stand up, which is, you know, kind of scary, you might say. Or it can be just kind of leaning up against something. And then you can also move the legs independently for more of a walking motion to kind of show it as it's going from place to place, like that. And you also saw that the tail is able to be rotated up and down. That's only on the adult. Only the adult has the tail that can move. The young one has the ability to do everything else, but the tail is just built in to the body itself. Everything else can be moved back and forth and up and down as you like. So there's that. Here's one more animal included in the set. The human animal, known as the researcher, could be involved in conservation efforts, just studying the wildlife in general. And this has got pretty nice detail on that inner shirt and a bunch of pockets, which makes a lot of sense. On the jacket, lots of pockets to hold on to different small little scientific instruments and things to capture and hold on to samples from the environment. Too bad this one does have some kind of smudges or some blemishes in the plastic, but it is a pretty nicely detailed figure from the front. It's also a pretty lucky figure because he gets to drive this really cool off-road vehicle, which looks like a Jeep to me. You could call it other things, but I think this most closely resembles a Jeep. Again, there could be other things it could be, but I'm just saying what it looks like to me. Now, this does have a little bit of articulation to its suspension, so you can make it look like it's actually going over some rough surface. You can only move the front, so I guess the rear moves just a little bit, but not as much. But I think that's pretty cool. Real rubber tires here. You can remove those tires. There's a spare on the back that you can actually remove if you want to swap those out and pretend that you got a flat tire that you need to change. They include a kind of a wrench tool for taking the caps off here, which allows you to remove these easily. It's got a jerry can back here, which is a fuel can, and this has a realistic feature to it as well. You can turn it around and get the spout that sticks out. You've got bars on the top, you've got lights on the top. These mirrors are actually mirrored. It's kind of hard to see here, but you can just start to see my finger showing up there. And you can take parts of this off. So you can take all this kind of camper section off. You can just leave it off if you want to. Just drive around in more of a pickup kind of style of look. Definitely looks more like a Land Cruiser that way. But just, you know, allows you to get better, easier access to what's going on in the back. In the back here, there is that tool that I mentioned, the wrench style tool, which allows you to get the wheel nuts off, kind of simulated wheel nuts. They gave you a couple extras of those as well. Plus, there's plenty of space for cargo. You can also remove just the top part here to get easier access into the inside. Just turn up the light a little bit so you can see that more easily. They give you enough room underneath the steering wheel for your figure to fit his feet under there. Go ahead and get that in. And there's what it looks like in the driver's seat. Kind of sits a little bit low, actually makes the whole vehicle look a little bit larger than it really is. Now, there's a bunch of extra stuff that's included with this set as well. It gets kind of overwhelming, really. You've got a fold-up table here where you can set up your experiments and be looking at stuff, but that does fold relatively flat, and you actually can put this into the back of the vehicle. Not everything will fit in there nicely, but this trunk right here, well, I'm gonna leave that for last. Look at this, a laptop with some displays, actually tracking some of the animals that are being researched. You get some plant specimens. I don't know if this is supposed to be a fungus or something more like a cauliflower. One of those two, whatever you want it to be. A calla lily specimen here, which can actually be plugged into the ground or integrated with some of the other foliage that we saw in the habitat. You get some carrots and peas here, which can be used for food for you, or you can offer it up as food for the animals. This is a little stove, a little outdoorsman stove. Just puts a little flame on the base there and you can cook things on top of it. You get this lantern here. Now let's get to what's inside of this trunk because there's a lot stuffed in here. I actually spent some time trying to fit as much into this as I could. Look at this, just spill it out. Look at all this stuff. It includes some tools, some bottles, a mug here, a very important flashlight. Also has a map which can be held by your figure. And the nicest thing here by far is this microscope because, well, first of all, it looks really nice and it's a great thing for doing research and checking out different samples. You can also go ahead and operate it. You can change the magnification setting between three different lens sets. So very realistic in that way as well. With a bunch of stuff stuffed back into this chest, you can just close that up. It's not gonna carry everything, but there is a spot where you can place this in the vehicle, fold up the table kind of flat and try to get all this in there at the same time. It's kind of a challenge, but you can start to kind of squeeze things in there, and you can kind of force some other stuff in as well, but you've also got some space up in the passenger seat. So I'll put, you know, important things like the laptop up there. All right, everything fit, kind of. Oh, it looks like he's about to move. He's packed so much stuff in there, but it is in there, so he is ready to go. Hey, what more need I say, really? This is just a great set. It's got a nice terrain piece. It's got nice animals and plenty of them. The vehicle is nice and just so many accessories to do so many things with. To me, this seems like a good value and just a win-win all around. So thank you for watching this video, and please share your thoughts about this set down in a comment below. Viewer feedback is always appreciated, and I'll be talking to you again very soon.